brothers and sisters, I'd love to see you again next year, if God wills and gives me that long life. But if not, I'd love to meet you in Jannah, inshallah.
Our next speaker, Adib. Your way. Assalamu alaikum. She made me cry. MashaAllah. I am happy to be here, alhamdulillah, to listen to brothers and sisters and get really, in cases, a kind of positively disappointed, not expecting from this brother to give such a great speech, insightful, or that sister, such a wonderful speech, and really having a feast of beautiful speeches. And for that reason, really, I was reluctant whether to come here or not. Maybe I'm just be taking your time for maybe something not worth of talking. I don't know, I want to start with something funny. And here it is. She talks very emotionally. And I like children. And I am a child too. I like children because they speak up their minds without really mask. Sure, it may hurt, but children's words do not hurt because they don't have the power to hurt us, to harm us. We are not intimidated by them. We can disregard, we can ignore. But there is something virtue in that. Yahya, for example, Cenobar called our home and Cenobar wanted to talk with me and Yahya told Cenobar, says, I don't like you, Cenobar. I love it. I wish I had that sincerity, that honesty, that I love all of you, really, with no doubt, but I don't like some people. In fact, I recently learned the difference between like and love. And I wish we were able to tell each other I don't like you and sit down why I don't like you, why you don't like me.
Well, I told you that. It's not the news. Boy, it took you a long time to arrive to that conclusion.
How can we say what I don't like about?
Yes. Anyway. Another kind of children's question is questioning things without fear of getting blamed. Less peer pressure, it seems, in certain ages. For example, recently my son asking questions about God. And one day, he gets information and now feedback reaction to the information says, Daddy, God created everything? Yes. Me? Yes. Trees, mountains, this dog, everything. And then the following question is, why God created bad guys? Believe me, I don't have an answer to you. I said, when you grow up, you learn. Another thing, we are encouraging him to pray with us. And one day, people in Masjid Tucson, they know these stories, I told them. This is a repetition. And then he was trying to pray with his shoes on. And then his mother told him, Yahya, don't pray with your shoes on. Says, no, I will pray my shoes on, it's okay. Says, no, because God says you cannot pray with your shoes on. His answer says, no, I didn't hear God saying that. Great. I didn't hear God saying that. You are making up.
Possible.
Anyway, I believe to be together in a religious community and having intimate relation and not having trouble in communicating with each other, it is impossible. Because religious communities are open communities. This is not an engineer club, which everybody has square mind engineer. Or this is not a kind of philosopher club. Everybody has skeptical viruses in their mind. Everybody questions without answers. This is a religious group which open to every kind of people. People from all cultures, all background, all level of education, all level of understanding, even open to mentally sick people, even open to hypocrites, even open to disbelievers maybe. For that reason, probably it will be a high expectation to expect trouble-free communication or argument-free days in conferences, I believe. Because we are all different, the information that we get, this is the Quran, we don't just get the information. We select the information first. By this way, each person selects different information, different combination of verses, different emphasis, and we analyze differently. We have a lot of assumptions in our mind. Previously, we accumulated. Some of them never questioned those assumptions. We have different way interpretation. We have different wishes, desires, interests, different agendas, and all adds to our understanding. For that reason, there will be diverse understanding of the same translation of the same Quran or original Quran. We shouldn't be highly expect that everybody uniform will be just like military, everybody will be the same. No. But in order to reduce the diversity, to make coherence, to create a kind of consistent community, there must be open way of communications. We must encourage it, sure, in best way. But when we stop it, communicating differences, when we raise our eyebrows to a person, ask some question, speaks his mind like a child, we put a wall in front of accumulating questions. It creates a dam and one day may explode. And I believe conferences must be a way to communicate things, not one by one, sometimes sit down together, discuss if there are issues, not to create issues. But I believe there are different issues. There are different approaches. And we are human beings and we are weak. Most of the time, we are prejudiced. If a person happened, we love that person, speaks a word, a statement, or a person we happened previously with for some experience we don't like, speaks exactly the same words, we may have entirely different reactions to the same statements just because the persons who spoke those words. That means we are not, when we communicate, when we listen to each other, we are not just analyzing the content of the things. We really pollute the content with our previous prejudice experiences. And knowing this helps us to have a better communication, understanding, inshallah. Also, respecting each other. When I personalize certain issue, I should be reminded by other brothers and sisters, don't make it personal. Because When we personalize, we get emotional, we are distracted, and we don't see the truth as it is. But I have experiences in these conferences, known as the troublemaker of the conferences, thank God. But I believe there was sometimes wrong treatment on your side, or some people probably didn't speak up. When my words was interrupted, that was okay. When I was insulted by other persons, I didn't see really my brothers and sisters weren't that person. Why you are making personal insult and attack to this person? He's raising a question. If he has bad intention in his mind, don't mind. Answer the question with a good argument. You will refute his argument and himself. But my concern, I have certain concern, because when I look at the history, how religious groups can close their minds to questions. If it is new group, in fact, all the people came through questioning things, questioning norms and traditions. They come to that group, and then they leave their minds slowly put out. In this group, we don't need anymore our mind. We don't need to question. And then flaws, problems, innovations start creeping in from here and there. And with time, no one will have the courage to ask any questions, because norms established, group is so powerful, and nobody dares can ask questions, and everything can enter. And all kind of deteriorations, distortions start when the last child is being expelled from the community, when everybody is adult with a thick mask on their face, with polite words, hiding the questions in their mind because of fear of pointed as a troublemaker. I want to share several things with you, and I don't want to share anything that I believe, inshallah, will create controversy. And this conference, I have a resolution that not to talk with something, inshallah, that would hurt anyone. One thing that, this will be a kind of potpourri speech, means the most disorganized speech. For this reason, bear with me. And in chapter 19, verse 23-25, if you open, that there is something that I noticed, but I might be wrong, but I want you to research about it. And it is about Mary. When Mary has birth contractions, pains, there is a sound comes underneath her. Sure, we can understand basically Jesus in her belly, or maybe sound in different way, and understand maybe angel. Anyway, there is a sound come to her, says, "Here is your Lord provided you with a stream underneath you, and go shake a tree and eat from the right day." Right day? Right, yeah. Anyway. And then later, I learned that water has a soothing effect on our muscles. When you see the water, automatically your muscles are regulated. And when a human being or an animal has rabies, yeah. And it creates a kind of hydrophobia, and also from the light, because light and water, both of them stimulates the muscles, and they have viruses in their muscles, and then it creates pain because seeing those things. And but recently they started using water for in hospitals to have birth, kind of mother when sees the water, her muscles get regulated and the contractions become more regular and smoother, and the birth is less painful, painless. And the date later, I learned somewhere in an article, but I'm not really sure about that, inshallah you research. I learned that date has high level of oxytocin in it. And then, once by accident, by chance, I was in Lamaze course with my wife when my wife was pregnant with Yahya. And then I heard the lady over there talking about oxytocin that doctors gave as a medication for to women when they have labor, before labor, in order to make it easier. And it's really, to me, just ringing bell to the date that has high level oxytocin in it, and water is one of the best for regulating the muscles. Here Mary has pains, contractions, and God tells her about these two things. There are so many things could be mentioned, but only these two things to me, that is significant. And there is another thing I want to share with you. In fact, I wrote in one of the little booklet that I said unorthodox articles about usury. I had a lot of questions about usury or the distinction between usury and interest. What is really that God prohibits? If it's the distinction only 20%, 21%, it is a kind of, without real clear cut, just distinguishing. I found that trouble, and probably most of you have certain questions about that. And later we're discussing, and I received a very detailed letter on it, on usury, and it opened up the question, and questions turned out to be challenges for me. And sure, there is one good thing, inshallah, I am learning to hold in my judgment. Holding judgment means to be able to live with ambiguities, be able to live with some questions in mind, not to rush, just to answer every questions you have. But our tendency is just to find answers to any question that we have, just get relieved, secure. But most of the answers that we get, if you rush, will be wrong, and we may get disappointed in our lifetime, or we may get become fanatic. But it is a good experience, inshallah. We learn that we have a problem, we have a question, but we sincerely look answer for that. If we couldn't find a satisfactory answer, okay, God, I don't have a brain infinite number of cells. I have a 3-pound brain. I have little information. Grant me with some information, inshallah, we'll find an answer for this. If I don't find, it doesn't matter, because I don't know everything, but the things that I know is enough for me to worship you alone and to follow Quran alone. And I was discussing with one of my friends in Massachusetts, Dr. Adi Soma. Oh, he can't. Just like mentioning your name. And he gave me a good insight, God bless him. I didn't know, he knew the answers that I was looking for years. And here is, we living together every Friday, we meet each other. This friend of mine, mashallah, keep hiding these valuable answers that I am looking for. I don't know why did you hide that so long. And then he told me something, oh my gosh, it really shifted my paradigm, perspective entirely changed, and my questions mostly became irrelevant. And to me, I found really very satisfying answer for my question regarding usury. And God bless him. Okay, after this, I don't have much time, I don't want to go. No, but still I keep myself, I might be wrong, and in that, but to me at this point, it is satisfying answer, huh?
1 point.
Yeah, go ahead, inshallah. If you see something to share with me, add more. I would like to hear from you, inshallah. Here, I have this is my last point, but it may a little bit take maybe 10 minutes, probably I have. Three issues, inshallah, I would like to raise and yet focus on this. One, to be sensitive towards personal attacks, not personalizing issues. Personally, I suffered from this, and probably some other people also suffered from this. If someone brings an issue, don't say you are a hypocrite, you are a liar, you are this and that. This is the cheapest way of argument. Believe me, I can reply with double, with multiple. It is the easiest way. You can do that. But I believe that we create certain hard feelings. I'm not saying I am not personalizing this. I also make the same mistake. I personalize things. And for that reason, be aware, inshallah, when we make the things personalized, diverting from the issue, and other brothers and sisters, when they see it, remind each other. And second, be aware of that this community is most likely repeat the history. I say most likely. And don't get just offended if someone raised the concern about idolization of the messenger in this context, Rashad, which I believe we have some of us get kind of uncomfortable when some people once a while raise this question. Generally, when we talk about idolization, we mean the ones outside of us, Mohammedans or Christians and others. We are immune of this. We got rid of it. And this, in fact, this false assumption, this sense of victory, creates exactly the witness that Satan is looking for, attack that time. And after Prophet Muhammad, the same happened. People, they got rid of idolization, and nobody could raise any question. All idolization was about Christians, they would idolize, Jewish people, or idol worshippers, but never Muslims. Never possible to worship Muhammad. If you talk with a Mohammedan, there are some people who worship Muhammad. No, never. How can you say? Because the mind is open just to criticize others, to the others, not to look at yourself. And I want to read a verse. 3144, inshallah, open the Quran. Muhammad was no more than a messenger, like the messengers before him. Should he die or get killed, would you turn back on your heels? Anyone who turns back on his heels does not hurt God in the least. God rewards those who are appreciated. We have and will have agents of reactionism, agents who wants to take us back to repeat the history instead of idolization. Muhammad this time, replacing Muhammad with Rashad, replacing hadith with appendices or footnotes or perspectives or video cassettes with more technological hadith. And please let's be aware. Let's know well why we rejected hadith. Please, for all of us, read the verses just also looking at ourselves, not just criticizing others. Recently I heard several things. One I wrote, I read the printout. One of the brothers who were delivering the message on the computer, referring to the translation of the Quran as the English version of the Quran. To me, it was very striking, a clear deviation from the truth. English version of the Quran, Arabic version of the Quran. If your English is not good enough regarding this word, please look at the dictionary, what does version mean? And I believe we should clarify, talk with each other if you have problems about the, what is the function